book.
Well, you've seen his work in Silver Linings Playbook. He created the book cover you saw there in that scene.
Artist Ross McDonald crafts mostly print-based props for movies and TV. Who knew this was a thing? You kind of just assume all these books and stuff you see are just, they exist somewhere.
Yeah.
But they're created by an artist, and he joins us now. Hi, Ross. How are you?
I'm good. Good morning.
So this is fascinating to me. You're an artist by trade, and I'm just curious how you got into this prop business.
Well, it was, meeting a guy at a cocktail party, actually. He knew my work, and he was starting work on Baby's Day Out, which was getting ready to film in Chicago. And they needed a faux 1930s children's book. And next thing I know, I got a call from John Hughes and worked in Chicago for 6 months. And that kind of started the ball rolling.
And Ross, it seems like, and compared to maybe some of the other artwork you do, that might be a pretty easy thing to do. Oh, children's fake book cover. Boom. Did it in 20 minutes. What goes into it?
Well, 20 minutes is the usual deadline, all right.
But,
it's a lot of background research on a lot of these things. That often eats up, 75, 80% of the time, because a lot of the things I'm working on are period props. And directors are really concerned about getting period props correct. And a lot of times they're very mundane things, like somebody's driver's license or, army enlistment form or some kind of police file or something that's very hard to track down. So you spend a lot of time just finding what these things look like.
And I think we've got, is this from Boardwalk Empire, or this looks like an Elliot Ness one you did. We had Nucky Thompson,
yeah.
You did his passport from Boardwalk Empire. And it's fascinating. I guess I always just assume they found these things somewhere.
Right. No, you usually, things like this are custom made by people like me.
And what have you learned about doing this that brings you to making maybe the artwork that you care more about or your main art job?
Well, it is funny. It does. There is kind of a feedback loop there. I oftentimes have to look at a lot of old illustration or old art, and I find those influences creeping into my illustration work for publications. I might, put a character in a period costume or it might have to do with the composition or the colors that I've been influenced by in my props research. But yeah, definitely it is an influence on my illustration work.
I see it looks like you're sitting in a prop room there. Are those some of the things you've created on the wall behind you?
Some are, yeah. Some are just old stuff that I've picked up in my travels. A lot of the stuff you see behind me is stuff that I pull out when I'm working on researching something. A director might say, I need an old ledger or I need an old bank book. There's a bunch of old typewriters behind me that I use for creating props, old check writing machines and check canceling machines and all kinds of crazy stuff like that. I use a lot of that stuff in my work, in my prop work.
Ross, I'm wondering how much respect the prop artist gets. Is there an Oscar award for best prop artist?
I wish. Yeah, there's not even an Oscar for prop master. These guys work so hard and they get so little recognition. Prop masters are responsible for everything that an actor touches in a movie, so that can be anything from glasses and rings and jewelry to guns, cigarettes, cars, all kinds of crazy stuff. And they're often working under a real deadline crunch and having to make sure everything looks right too and please the director. It's a very difficult job.
So you're not only creating the artwork for these, but a lot of times are you scouring what I'm assuming are like flea markets where you're finding some of these things?
Yeah, definitely.
Wow.
I got a taste of that at a great flea market near Chicago when I was working on Baby's Day Out. The set decoration team went out and bought tons of stuff for background in the scenes, things like lamps and kitchen stuff and all kinds of stuff like that. They got it at the flea market, and I'm lucky enough to have a really good flea market near me. So, you know, a lot of times when I'm working on a period piece, I'll go out and scour the flea market and pick up stuff that might just be for research purposes or for inspiration. And sometimes I'll get enough to get stuff that they can use in the show.
Yeah. Well, for more information on Ross, you can head to his website, ross-mcdonald.com. Ross, great to meet you.
Very nice to meet you. Thank you.
Thanks, Ross.